Hello and welcome. My name is Jonathan Banks, and I am a third-year DMD PhD student at the UIC College of Dentistry. Thank you for joining us for this groundbreaking video series, which will showcase our exceptional researchers and their pioneering research topics. As a student researcher, I've witnessed firsthand the research excellence at our college, which you will experience today. Now, it is my privilege to introduce Dr. Afsar Naqvi, Associate Professor in Periodontics, who will impress us with the remarkable potential of saliva. Dr. Naqvi.
Thank you, Jonathan, and hello, everyone. Today, I'm going to talk about the research we have been doing in our lab to investigate the power of saliva and how we can achieve better oral health by disease monitoring and control. In our lab, we investigate gum disease, the sixth most common human disease affecting more than 1 billion people worldwide. This disease has multiple components, including viruses and immune effector cells that can contribute to the disease pathogenesis. The interplay between the viruses and immune cell is the focus of my lab and today's talk. So, before going into the gum disease, I would like to tell you about what we have in our body, who we are. As humans, we are 30 trillion cells, 40 trillion bacteria, and a whopping number of 400 trillion viruses. Of all the microbes that we contain in our body, about 20% of them call mouth their home. We live in harmony with these microbes. However, poor oral hygiene, environmental factors, and genetic susceptibility can cause gum inflammation. If not controlled, this inflammation can slowly damage the tissues that support our tooth and can cause tooth loss, affecting our quality of life. So, it is important to understand how the inflammation plays a role and what are the microbes that can add to that inflammation. Importantly, these microbes and immune activity does not stay in our mouth, but spread beyond. And when it spreads to the other part of our body, it can cause inflammation and contribute to disease. So this disease is being associated with other non-oral diseases, including heart disease, gut disease, and arthritis. So it is important to understand how viruses and immune cells contribute to periodontal disease, or the gum disease, and how it affects the systemic disease itself. In our lab, we are interested in studying the role of virus in gum disease. These viruses are present in our mouth, different sites of our mouth. But in case of gum disease, they come in large numbers and accumulate at the site of disease. On the left, you see a gum disease site around tooth, and on the right, you see gum disease around an implant. There are different viruses that you can see, and they come in large numbers. What we have learned is that viruses associate with the disease, but what do they do? And how we can monitor these viruses is an important question in understanding gum disease. We use saliva as an important tool because saliva captures multiple kind of information, including viruses, immune cells, different types of DNA, RNA, bacteria, and different metabolites. And this makes saliva an extremely rich biological biospecimen. Through monitoring saliva, we can identify what is present in there and have a better information about how the disease is progressing. But how these immune cells make their way into the saliva? So in this animation, you can see that immune cells constantly move in to the gum tissues and make their way out of the gum tissues, finding into the saliva. When we capture the saliva, we know what is present in those tissues. And it can give us an idea about what is happening to our oral health. So in our lab, we have learned a great deal of knowledge about saliva-contained information. And these immune cells that are present in saliva are helpful for our oral health, and they also are helpful in maintaining the oral health by capturing, by containing the growth of the microbes. On the left, you see gum disease. On the right, you see gum disease, wherein there is growth of microbes happening, and you need to have a lot more types of immune cells to come and control the growth of microbes. Through our saliva-based studies, we have learned that patients who receive dental treatment, they have lower virus burden and immune cell burden, indicating a strong link between the inflammation, viruses, and gum disease. However, not all the patients who receive dental treatment for gum disease show equal response. So understanding which patients respond or which patients don't is very critical for clinicians to provide better oral health care to them. We've also understood that in case of non-oral disease like COVID, there is higher propensity of pathogenic opportunistic microbe present in the oral cavity, more inflammation in the gums, and higher burden of viruses in the oral cavity, linking a non-oral infection versus an oral disease, which is very important to understand and give better treatment to patients who come up with such a disease. Finally, we are also investigating how patients who are younger compared to the older patients presenting with gum disease be better treated for the disease, and how we can see the differences between young and old patients. This way, we can give specific treatment that'll cater to the needs of patients coming with the gum disease. So what we have learned through our saliva-based research is saliva is a great tool to assess viruses and immune cells, and it can help pave new research avenues to study the relationship between immune cells, viruses, and the gum inflammation. We think that this information would be very valuable for the clinicians to provide better treatment to the patients, help monitor the progression of disease, and assess the effectiveness of dental treatment. We think that saliva could be equivalent of blood. The way we use blood to monitor our overall health, we can use saliva to monitor routinely our oral health. And in that direction, we are moving slowly but steadily to use saliva as a window for our overall oral health. And to do that, we will continue to unravel the potential of saliva. Thank you for your time.